a system of morality veiled in allegory and illustrated by symbols. Now, symbols, we're used to seeing some of them. I'm sure you've seen the square and compasses or different symbols related to Freemasonry. But patterns and music are some of the rich ways in which we can convey some lessons to the men who have gone through the system of Freemasonry. Now, if you were to ask, how does Freemasonry make good men better, as they claim? And it is by instilling in them lessons through very memorable rituals, very memorable morality plays that help them in their journey through life to recall those lessons, apply them to their life as they interact with the rest of the world. So here we'll give you a glance into some of the journey that these men go through in their ritual practice in order to become a better man. And to illustrate this, we have today Brother Joscar Poerschke, and this is Masonic Avant-Garde.
Thank you.
piece you just heard is titled, Who Comes Here? Now, if you think of the initiatic process that a Freemason goes through, in order for someone to join Freemasonry, they have to ask another member. Now, if this person is found to be a good candidate, the lodge that will welcome them into the order, they have to do some diligence. They have to get to know this man. They have to get to make sure that this is a man that is going to improve the repute of the organization, that it's not going to tarnish it in any way. And it is symbolic here in this piece when this man is becoming or approaching the initiatic experience of Freemasonry. You can imagine a young man today as he could have 100, 200 years ago, once found worthy or well qualified to be a part of this organization, once he steps foot into a Masonic lodge for his ceremony, he would encounter music like this, accompanied by other different performances that will help him remember the lessons that he's about to embark. So this represents that beginning stage in a man's life. The next piece represents the moment of that man being born into Freemasonry. This piece is titled, It Is in God I Am Light. Give you, before we move to the next piece, a little background on Joscar. Joscar has been playing piano or learning the craft since he was 5 years old. As a homeschooled young man, he had the privilege of having a father who is a talented musician as well, and also having private tutors helping him develop the craft. Like his father before him, he petitioned to join the Order of Freemasonry. And once given admittance, in 2011, he was raised to the sublime degree of Master Mason, which is the third degree of Master Mason. I'm sure you've heard giving the expression, someone being given the third degree, that alludes to that achievement in a man's life. Shortly thereafter, in 2012, is when he began putting his talent to the service of crafting this beautiful music you are enjoying tonight. The next piece that you will hear is inspired by the early moments in the life of a man as a Mason, taking those first steps of implementing some of the lessons of Freemasonry into their personal life. Just like any other thing that we learn, we need guidance. We need someone next to us who has experience that can guide us to be as efficient as we can in implementing these things. And this song alludes to that. The piece is titled, What I've Learned. That is the third piece in the section that is inspired by the Entered Apprentice degree, or the first degree in Freemasonry. Now we move on to the second section, which is inspired by the Fellow Craft degree, or the second degree in Freemasonry. The first piece of the degree represents us as a work in progress, striving to really implement the lessons of morality and ethics that we want to display in our lives. It also alludes to the challenges that put those efforts to test. The next piece is titled, Whence Come You, Whither Traveling. Thank you. The second piece in the fellow craft degree section represents that final product that we become. It alludes to that sense of fulfillment for reaching a milestone worthy of our efforts. This next piece is titled Keep Me Steadfast. The third piece in the fellow craft degree is related to that cycle that I'm sure we're all familiar with, in which you focus on becoming better at one thing, only to find out that there's just another aspect of you that has to be evolved. When we speak with a man who is part of the fraternity, we try to instill in them the importance of always being mindful of that there is still, there's more to learn. There's more that you can do to perfect yourself. this is part of the ritual that seems to be almost like a graduation. It is part of a ceremony in which we celebrate how much knowledge a man has attained, but it also reminds him there's more work to be done. This next piece is titled Winding Staircase. We now arrive at the third degree in Freemasonry, also called the Master Mason degree. The first piece in the Master Mason degree represents the moments before death. Death looms over all of us. We think of it often. And there seems to be a connotation of negativity, or there's something that is sad, there's something that's bad about it, but we recognize it's just part of the cycle of life. And in the teachings of Freemasonry, it plays a role of reminding a man of the limited time he has on earth, thereby the importance of living a life well lived and being able to leave something for the future. In the lodge of Freemasonry, the third degree of Freemasonry is the last degree, at least in what we call the Blue Lodge, which are the first three degrees of Freemasonry. Like death, it ends very light and quick, similar to someone's last breath. This piece is titled, So Mote It Be. Thank you. The second piece in this degree takes place shortly after death. I would imagine it would be very peaceful, as there are no longer worries to burden you. But here the candidate, or not the, the brother, the man who is going through the ritual, should be at peace knowing that all the hard work that he's put is going to elevate him to a sublime degree. The next piece is titled Remembrance of Me. The last piece in the Master Mason degree is quite thought-provoking. When Joscar conveyed to me that whenever he was composing it, he was thinking of that common understanding that before a person passes away, their lives flashes before their eyes. And it makes you wonder, is that possible? Is it possible that once we reach that moment of departure, so to say, can we review our life in just an instant? The next piece is titled Hope for the Widow's Son.
Thank you.
That concludes the portions of the performance that relate directly to the ritual of the first, second, and third degree in Masonry. Now, there are other aspects of the organization that carry with them a level of respect, a level of reverence, which we try to inculcate into all our members. Men join Masonry from all religious backgrounds, and they're able to, within one roof, work together to become an improved individual, regardless of what religious background they may have or different views. This piece is an example of that sort of practice. It was composed for the prayer ceremony, a prayer that accompanies every single meeting. The next piece is titled, Lead Us in Prayer. The next piece is composed for the opening ceremony of a lodge meeting. It is designed to put a man's mind in the right place for the labor he is about to perform, in essence, reminding him of the importance of what he is about to do, which is to become a better man and by consequence impact the people around him. The next piece is titled Three Great Lights.
Thank you.
The next piece is composed for the various duties of the senior deacon in the lodge. There are various officers within the lodge, and they perform different duties. And this one is playing while the senior deacon is performing his duties. It is titled The Senior Deacon's Waltz. The next piece was composed for the balloting ceremonies or the voting ceremonies that we go through. If you imagine when a candidate expresses a desire to become a Freemason, fills out a petition, hands it in, it needs to go through a process where the members of the lodge get to know a little bit more about the individual and ascertain whether this is a person that should be entrusted with the things and the knowledge that we bestow. As you can imagine, for those who are already members of the fraternity, this is a very solemn moment. They're casting a decision whether this man's life changes, and now he becomes a part of our family. This piece is titled The Ballot Box. Thank you. The next piece was composed for our intermission ceremony. This may be typical during festive boards, and these are moments in which brothers come together, they have a meaningful meal together, and different elements transpire that inspire them to engage in conversation, to become better man, as it's throughout the entire presentation. It is titled, What is the Hour? The last piece of the Masonic avant-garde composition is designed for our closing ceremonies. Just like the opening ceremonies that I talked about earlier, in which we encourage a man to put their mind in the right frame so that they can do their work in an effective manner, there's a similar role to this piece. It is designed to help a man now have the mentality that what they've acquired within the meeting, now it's their responsibility to implement it into their lives and by consequence impact society with their actions. This piece is titled Part Upon the Square.
Thank you.
This is one that is designed specifically to help a man make the decision to really take to heart the lessons that he's about to be presented with and truly become a better man. The first piece is titled Vitriol. The next piece is titled Skull.
Thank you.
The final piece of the night is titled Mercury.